Yo, I looked around today on the internet and I seen this post that stated obesity in children. Now, so it was a little article, a little clip, talking about the disconnect between the youth that we have today. Well, as I looked around and I scoured, I did my thing. I noticed that there is a big, big disconnect between this generation of youth and the generation which I came up in. I'm not that old. I'm a young buck, but it's a big disconnect. There's also a post running around that stated, don't quote me on it, but something about how we have all this technology and the rise of technology is gonna give birth to a generation of dummies, stupid people, uneducated people. And I mean, it's coming truth. It's bearing its fruits now. As an advocate for health and fitness, physical fitness, staying in shape, I see this as a big issue. And it's an issue that I have a problem with. Like, I just don't agree with the fact that today's youth here in America are overweight. Sure, you could blame the parents, but look at what's given to them. Look at what's around. Youth are no longer being encouraged to go out and run, go out and play. Not enough playgrounds. Right? We spend all this time arguing over money and what needs to be in schools and taken out of schools. They took out one of the most important factors. I mean, it was a key factor, a key role player in school, which was gym, PT. Physical fitness, physical education, whatever VE, whatever you want to call it. There is a big factor, a big role player, a key role player at that. In the youth, the generation. They went outside, they played, we had monkey bars. Tag, which you can't even play tag no more because now it's considered sexual harassment. Ask yourself that. Come on, I'm in the fifth grade, third grade. What do I know about sexual harassment? It's called tag. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna go around. Freeze tag. Come on now. Kickball. Dodgeball. Man, let me tell you the story about dodgeball. See, there was. This was elementary school, and I'm not gonna throw any names out. Where a kid got reprimanded because he threw a dodgeball at a kid. He threw a ball at the kid, a bouncy ball, one of those red bouncy balls. At another child while in a game of dodgeball, and a kid got hurt. Not seriously, just a little owie. Should have ducked, in my opinion, but it's dodgeball, man. Innocent game. No intentions. That's what the kid used, which, matter of fact, I don't even want to say it was a kid used. I used it to express myself, to actually get away from the issues that was going on in school. How you relieve stress. Great stress reliever is running, burning it out. We ran the track. They put us out there in the jungle gym. You was out there for hours messing up your school clothes. That was the issue I seen in it. But now, we have kids who, I mean, I hate to say it, but these kids are weak. They're soft. And that I will blame on the parents. I will, because as a parent, you have a responsibility in raising your child to the best of your ability. If your child is 80% over his average weight, and it's not a mental or physical condition that's causing it, that's an issue that relies on you. You can't blame fast food. That's a new age thing. That's a new generation thing, as the old folk call it. GMOs. blame the food industry. It ain't the food industry fault. They've been there for years. It's you as a parent fault. The burger is too big at McDonald's. It's causing the kids to get fat. Who's giving the food to the kids, man? Who's giving it to them? You, the parent. You are providing your child with the nourishment from McDonald's, Burger King, Wendy's, Dairy Queen, Sonic's. You know, I could go on and on and on and on. In-N-Out Burger here in California. Yeah. Well. But as I drive around, I see a Burger King, McDonald's, Wendy's, In-N-Out, Five Guys, all on the same strip, but I see not one park. Or I see a park, but just open field. Which, I mean, you get a great, good game of tag if no one's going to, no parent, you know, or lobbyist, liberal, congressman, you know, politician, you know, political leader. They're not going to run out and scream, oh, that's sexual harassment. Can't play tag. Stop it. All right. I see the issue of the kid gets hit on his private areas, his no-no areas. But in the innocent game of tag, I really feel like we need to look at ourselves in the mirror and let's reevaluate what we're trying to put blame on. But you have an open field with no recreational use. But now, I mean, everything that's physical fitness, you know, has a physical fitness interest or, you know, a fitness interest is always targeted to adults. The generation, my generation and above, I mean, we already know the solution to the problem. It's the generation now that doesn't have the solution to the problem. And where is that relying? It relies on the leadership. And who are the leaderships? Myself, because I'm here talking about it, because I see the problem and now I have to come up with a solution. Because if you can't have a problem without a solution, because if you have no solution, well, you just deal with your problem until you find a better one. That's just the downright truth. And I do have a solution. It's called getting fitness. All right. Bringing fitness back, bringing it, making it fun, making it inventive. It doesn't have to be boring. It doesn't be, you know, an old ritual. Let it be new. Let it be nourishing. All right. Bring it back. So now we have to get the disconnected children connected and online with the process of working out. Why? Why do we leave them, you know, lost? We have them in a world where it's hard for them to find an outlet for stress. That's why we have these things called cyberbullying. That's a whole nother topic, and I'm going to talk about that a little later. That's a whole nother topic, but there wouldn't be no cyberbullying if the kids wasn't spending all their time on the internet and not actually outside playing or working out. You know, working out doesn't always have to be hard, all right? It can be fun, too, all right? Go outside, play some double dutch, you know? Kids don't play double dutch in the yard no more, you know? It's not a game of basketball just springing up in the middle of the street, you know? Was it dangerous? To some degree, maybe, you know, but it was a neighborhood. They knew to be careful because kids were outside playing. Nowadays, all the kids are focused on trying to be a rapper, you know? Trying to be, you know, a gangster, you know, because that's coming back, you know? Wow, like it ever went anywhere, but that's not the truth, all right? You have a strong group of boys and girls out there who are actually getting fit and growing and becoming something better of themselves through fitness. And it all starts with a natural outlet of some positive energy. Taking that negative energy, turning it into a positive. Because trust me, once you work out long enough or you get active enough, you throw a kid outside to play, don't tell him, don't come outside. You know, we drink hose water. You know, now we worried about the fluoride in the water. I drank from the water hose when I was thirsty, all right? Because you couldn't go in and out. Go in, you stay in. Yeah, some of you people don't know about that, but yeah, that was a rule, you know, in my neighborhood, where I'm from. You know, you go inside, you staying in, you know. all your friends are outside having a good old time. You inside looking miserable. Nowadays, all the kids are inside. And the only ones outside are actually, you know, not maybe not even doing anything productive, but we're going to get them on track too. But that's just my little insight on what I saw, you know, expressing my feelings. Blogging, or vlogging, if you want to say that. But to next time. Next topic I'm going to talk about is going to be cyberbullying, because that's something that needs to be brought up. Peace.